And with this program, basically, we'd probably have to order somewhere between 400 and 500 cans for our initial order, a truckload of cans. Those cans can consist of any mix of 95, 65, and 35-gallon waste containers. These containers can be customized in any color we want. If we wanted to do the Wooddale green with the, and we can even put our logo on there if you wanted to do the logo. That's a one-time $500 fee for the logo, but it can be imprinted on each can, and the can can be green or khaki or blue or any color we wanted to have it. And then once we ordered the 400 to 500 containers, what we can do is we could either A, have residents come pick them up themselves, or we could B, just have our vendor go and deliver those cans to their houses if they wanted to do that. There are some municipalities doing this. I have a list. It's not in front of me. But also the containers are warranted for 10 years. And there's no extra charge to the residents. They just pay the one-time fee for the can. And then for 10 years, if a wheel busts off, we tell the vendor, they look at the serial number, they bring out a new can to that resident. If the lid breaks or there's a hole in the can, then they replace that as well.
Alderman Winger.
I have concerns with doing this, but one of my biggest concerns with the plan of taking delivery of between 430 and 450, we would need to first make sure that we have at least 350 to 400 homes that really want this, because I don't want to go buy 450 garbage cans and be sitting on them for you know, a couple of years and no one buying them from us. So that's my first concern. And secondly, I'm part of the pilot program as well. And on the positive, we were testing out to see if another provider would use the can, and it does work. A different provider can pick up the can. But the problem with it is it gets in the garage, but if the car is in the garage, we can't get it out of the garage. So it's too tight of a fit, and so we're not necessarily liking the can. But on the positive, it does work for other providers. Thank you.
Marshall.
And for the record, Alderman Winger, you have you and your husband and no other people producing garbage in your family, so you are unique, and you probably produce very low amounts of garbage in your household versus other families that have multiple children, so on and so forth. With respect to, can we store 400 of them, number one? Okay, for the record, he's saying no. I think if we still do it as an optional program, you could say, tell the residents, you can sign up for it, and we're not going to order them until we get 400 people to sign up for it. So then it'll be a little bit of, hey, do you want to get one of these? We got to get 400 people, and the first 400 sign up. I don't know if our vendor would deliver them, because if we're not using BFI to...
No, that's part of their program. They'll deliver them to every resident's house.
BFI will?
Allied?
Who we buy them from.
The distributor of the cans, yeah. Who we
so
buy them
maybe
from.
If we don't say, we just say until we get 400 bought, that's when they're going to get ordered. That's when we'll get purchase them. And maybe it's only twice a year, so people have, you can buy them in the winter and the summer, and then that's it until you get 400 each time, and we do them in a 400 lot. Otherwise, though, again, for people like the Shawkeys, like the Wingers, who don't like them, don't want them, they don't have to have them. They don't have to pay for them. But what other people that do like them can get them, and it's a nice option we can offer the residents.
Okay. I'm on calls.
Put my name down for the first one.
Okay. Let me.
And my neighbor.
I. Oh, tell me.
Well, since we're, is everybody done talking about the garbage cans?
No, I'm not.
Okay. Well, because I want to talk about it, but since we're talking about this type of program, I would like to bring up something in relationship to it, as long as we're talking about this program. I'm not looking for any vote.
Okay. But can I finish?
Yeah, go right
one
ahead.
One other question, and then I'll come back to you. The only thing I didn't see on his memo is what was the price of those garbage cans? I mean,
$53.
I don't, looking through this memo, I didn't see the price of different sizes on what cans will cost what, unless I'm missing it somewhere.
It should be on the third page of the memo. It says Company A and Company B.
Doesn't have a 35 gallon.
That's what
I just found that out today. The 35 would be $40.
Okay, $40. Okay. All right.
And some of the prices on the other cans have actually gone down for one of the proposals.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman, then Jeff, with respect to paying for them, if we did do at the council meeting a rebate of some kind, if Joe's family wanted one, the city would buy them all once we get the 400 people. And then we could tell the people either you can get, if it's $50, it'll be, you know, $5 on your bill for the next 10 months, and then that would come off. Alternatively, you get $25 off, and then
we add it to your bill, off the bill.
Yeah, add it to the bill. I'm sorry. Could we do it that way for people paying for it?
As far as purchasing the cans, I had a discussion with Ms. Power. She envisioned if we wanted to incorporate some kind of a rebate. Is that what you're talking about?
Right.
We envision that they'd be charged for the can on their utility bill, and then the rebate would be taken off the charge of the can, all within the utility bill.
I just think, Marshall, your idea is it's going to be a nightmare with the finance department if we do that. I think they should be charged for it and then give them the rebate back in that perspective if we go that route.
I'll let staff handle that however they want to handle it.
I spoke to Ms. Powers this morning, and she said that would actually be the smoothest way to do it.
Oh, hey. Okay. I'm correct. Wrong. I mean, I guess.
Won't be the last time. Tonight, maybe. I'm sorry.
Low blow. Please don't speak unless you ask the chairman, okay?
Absolutely.
Call me.
Low blow.
Yeah, as long as you're talking about the waste cans and all, one of the areas I think that we need to look at is the other night I had an opportunity to meet with some residents in the ward, and they suggested we do a program in conjunction with what we're already doing to start pushing recycling again. And one of the things that they brought up was that, you know, when we first started the program a few years ago, everybody got a free can. And one of the things that they recommended was that maybe it would be a good idea as new people come in, new residents come into the ward or into the city, and they sign up for water and sewer, that we give them a free can at that time and a little blurb on the recycling program and what it's about. And I just thought that was a good idea. And since we're talking about waste, I thought it would be a good time to bring that up, because I may not get it brought up again. So
I thought that was understanding that when a new resident comes in that they do get that. No. Yes, going to Mr. Gary Holmes, he's nodding his head.
Yeah, we got, and that's why I shook my head no with regards to storage of the rolling cans, because I know we've got at least 100, if not close to 200, recycling bins in our building.
Exactly, and they're not going nowhere.
They sit down, there's a stack of them in finance.
Right.
Finance comes in and gets a small stack every once in a while.
Right, and that's the ones that they're selling, though, to the residents. What I'm talking about is when a resident moves in, and that's what these people, like we did with the first program, where when we first started it up, everybody in the city received a free can.
You can do it whenever you establish a new water account.
Exactly. Right? That was their idea, and I thought it was a good idea.
He said they do it now?
They're selling them. What they do is they bring them to the finance department now, and when people need new ones, they come in and buy them, purchase them.
I agree on it.
But if it's a new resident, we should give it to them with how it works.
Oh, yeah. I was under the impression that we do that. I apologize. I didn't know that. Okay. Okay. Is there any more on this garbage can? Because it's every time. Any direction you're looking for here? Are we looking?
I think I've got my direction. I guess we're going to bring it back to committee with a more detailed report for a report and recommendation, a refined report.
So you're fine, everyone. Any other questions? Okay, get off the garbage can now. Okay, my next item on agenda is discussion of hair noise capillary commission. All right, This was asked to be put on agenda due to the fact that this organization that we are members, no, we are not members of, that made a comment in our minutes. We do attend the meetings or we get the copies of minutes, and I believe Mr. Ptolemy asked for this to be put on agenda to be discussed on a comment that was made in the minutes from this committee saying that basically, Wooddale don't need any soundproofing. This was information item. So anyone want to address this tonight? I know Jeff doesn't have anything new to add to this. Ptolemy.
Yeah, I actually wanted this on, not just as an informational item. I wanted this on as a report and recommendation because I think it's time. I think it's time. I mean, you know, we've talked about this before, and I think it's time that the city joined us. And, you know, I mean, I know in the past we've talked about, well, we didn't want to get out of sock because, you know, possibly they owe us some money. But from my perspective, okay, you ain't never going to see a dime from sock, okay, because we can't even get them to give us any information to begin with. And, you know, I'm to the point where it's like, you know what? All the money that we potentially could get back from them is already spent. It's already been budgeted for, paid for. It's gone. The city's lost those funds. So why don't we just say, you know, farewell to SOC, because as soon as we join this organization, we're going to be thrown out of SOC. But at this point, I think we need to have a voice because this is the group that is making the decisions on who or who shouldn't be soundproofed, and they have a lot of input. And if we don't have somebody that's there and actively on that board, I think that Wooddale is going to get slammed. Now, eventually, when the final phase two goes through on O'Hare, the O'Hare modernization, you know, and the final funding comes in on phase two, what's going to happen is they're going to be mandated by federal law, okay, by the FAA, to soundproof all the impacted homes. But we still need to be involved now and have a voice now. So that, you know, I was hoping we could do that tonight, but I would ask who?
Oh, manager. Oh, no, Mr. Mayor, that's for something else on the agenda.
Yeah.
If I could, Mr. Chairman, the committee did pass to join, and it did go to council and was tabled at council. And we have not gone further with this because of the discussion as Alderman Ptolemy had brought out. So it was tabled at the council meeting.
Omer Shirk, go on.
You did say me?
Yes.
Okay. Just a couple of things. I'm not, in my mind, sure which way to go yet. But I do know that as of Wednesday, the DuPage Republican Party voted that they are still going to fight O'Hara about the airport extensions, the runway extensions, and I heard there that they are out of money at this point, and they're going to the airlines to try and get the money, and the airlines are turning them down. I don't know if it's exactly the right time to drop out of SOC or to stop our opposition in some way to the airport. We still need to do that because they're having difficulties, and there's no sense in making it easier for them.
Oh, yeah. wait, I have a comment first that I'll call in. The problem I have here, and the real problem I have here is SOC has not come forward with a finance statement of what they have done in the past, okay? And the drawback I have in that, we haven't seen anything. We don't even know if the money that we put into that is even existing anymore in that account. The thing is, with this organization, I think this organization will be able to soundproof more homes. Right now, we are getting a major runway, and that's going to be pointed. And I'll tell you that runway, I'll be able to hand a drink up to these people because we're going to have that extension down that area. The reason why I'd like to go this route is, and I'll be totally honest with you, no statements has come. We have asked for it. We have not got any info if the money is still there. The other issue is there's a lot of homes in this town that need soundproofing, bottom line. I mean, even in your ward, citywide. And to not, and going to this organization, they're going to push us off to the side because they figure, oh, Wooddale, forget. They are a member of the organization. We are going to lose a possible commitment to soundproof more homes if we don't go with this organization. I mean, that's where I stand. Unless someone's going to come back here tomorrow, next Thursday night, and bring me a finance statement of what's left in that account and what Sox has been doing for the past 2 or 3 years, and I did make a promise that I would continue to fight O'Hare on Sox. But if I got an opportunity to join another committee to make more soundproofing in this community, I really think the people deserve that more than continuing to fight in the battle and not doing nothing in their community.
I think here you're at the point here though where you can really do a win-win situation for the city and the residents. And how, I think, first off, is by getting out of SOC and by joining the O'Hare Noise Compatibility. By joining that commission, it doesn't prevent the city from being opposed to the expansion. Okay, there's a lot of groups, there's a lot of communities that are part of this commission today that are still opposed to the expansion. I think that, you know, SOC served its purpose. It did it great while it was there, but I think at this point it's really become a moot point, and we need to look at what are we going to do in protecting our residents. And I think that joining the O'Hare Noise Compatibility Commission is the first step. Okay, is it the end all? No, but it's the first step. And I further believe that we can still say we're against expansion. But I will tell you, and I've said this before publicly, and I'll say it again. In November, I had an opportunity to see what was going on in the airport grounds. I had a tour. And I will tell you that the runway that directly comes over Ward 4 today is being expanded 3,000 feet. The runway is already dug out. They were waiting to be able to pour the concrete or whatever it is that goes into the ground. That will be done by 2008. So that means those planes that fly over our ward today are going to be coming in much lower. And when I asked the question, they couldn't originally tell me. They did get back to me in an email, and they did say, depending on where you are within the flight path, it could be anywhere from 100 to 300 feet lower than they are today. That is an impact to our residents. And I think, you know, we can't, you know, we can debate this. We can. You know, argue about it forever and ever. But I think the time is now that we join this commission so we can get a strong voice on that and that committee and start representing the people of our city.
Well, ironically, tonight, an hour before the meeting, I got a phone call from Joe Karaganis, somebody I haven't spoken to in a year. and he had heard this was on the agenda tonight.
Did he send you a bill?
But he did want me to convey that he would like to come before the committee and share with you everything that SOC is doing and the status of the litigation and the fight before the district court or the appellate court in Washington and also here in Chicago. He further advised that it would be illegal for them to shift soundproofing money away from Wooddale, that they are required to do it on a worst first basis. So he asked that before the committee makes any final recommendation on this, that he be allowed to give a presentation of SOC side.
But Mike, I'm sorry, is that it,
Mr. That's Mayor?
That's it. Mr. Coles, and then I'll bring up my statement. Go ahead, Mr. Coles.
All right. If they ever put in the south runway, I realize the people that live on the north side of the town, through Ward 4, is getting all the airplanes most of the airplanes, not all of them, because they bend out on Irvin Park, they come right over my house. And the people in Ward 1 and 2 will be eventually having the same thing if they put in the south runway. So, I mean, my house was built 72, and it don't have the sound effects. They don't they'll have the airplanes coming over. We don't have a picture in our house that's straight anyway, because the foreign planes that take off are fully loaded, and they come over. I can wave at the people in the windows when they make the bank, and all the pictures in my house are on an angle, and I straighten them out, and the next plane comes over, they go on an angle again, so I leave them now. And that's been the last, about 2 years or 3 years. So when that south runway comes in, we're going to have the same thing that you got in the fourth ward. And people are complaining about planes now making noise.
I agree.
Yeah.
So I'm going to chart.
Yeah, according to the minutes we received last week on that O'Hara Sound Commission. Oh, by the way, I agree with everything you say. And even right now, Ward 2, there's people I know that have bought very expensive windows, and every single one of them has lost the seal, the double windows. So it is a big problem. But in the minutes, it showed who was there. I would like to make sure that if we join that commission, that we would have somebody on the board itself. Because as what happened with those minutes, somebody from the Splains just decided after a discussion on Wooddale to take it all away from Wooddale. And there's got to be something there just besides joining it. We have to have a real say in what's going on with it.
Mr. Rooms?
The way I understand it, any member has a say, and it's open to the public, and anybody can attend. And we were sending a representative. Jeff was going until we figured out that since you can't really say anything because you're not a member, we get the minutes, and we monitored the minutes. As soon as we saw that in the minutes, we sent it out because we have been monitoring. We have been aware of everything. I know that Alderman Ptolemy has been reading all the minutes. He's been giving the information out to the residents in the ward and keeping everybody up to date. And when that came in, you know, the system manager said, look at this. And I said, yes, we better put it in the packet and give the council an update. So once you remember, you have a say.
Okay. Mr. Mayor, Mr. Marshall.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I think that I understand the concerns, but again, because this was already tabled once at council, I think it should go straight back to council. It doesn't need to go to committee. But I think I don't see any harm in at least hearing the other side from Mr. Karaganis as to, because my understanding, and I don't know what, sometimes you don't know what fact or fiction is, but that this group was originally set up by the city of Chicago and was basically an extension of the city of Chicago. Whether or not that's true or continues to be true, I don't know. Whether or not they are the only ones that decide which ones get soundproofing, I think it'd be worthwhile to have some of that information presented to us, and even have both sides kind of present at a future council meeting or committee meeting to the group, and then whoever the board is can make a fully informed decision as to, yes, we want to join. Because I can't think that just, you know, there are laws that they're going to have to abide by, and I wish we would have got the colored map, but, you know, I don't know if the decision was made because the decibel levels that the FAA shows is that some of Wooddale's going to go down. So is that the reason that we're not going to get the additional soundproofing, or is it because actually we're not a part of this group? I don't know exactly what's fact or fiction there, and at least get an opportunity to hear them, the other side out.
Alderman Ptolemy.
Yeah, Marshall, this is one time, one of the many times I disagree with you. From my perspective, okay, we have already lost out so much for our city by not being involved, you know, with this group. Now, you said, was it political? Maybe originally when it first started, but they have been charged with making sure that all of the areas around the airport are soundproof. That is their responsibility. And they have to do it fairly, they have to do it equitably, and they have to do it, part of it is mandated by the FAA on what they have to do. I think that for, you know, for to sit here one more time and listen to, no offense, but to Joe Karaganis tell me about SOC and how great they are and everything they've done. I don't care what they've done in the past. I said, their day, it was great, and what they're fighting on is great, okay? We haven't paid dues in almost 2 years now to SOC, okay? And because their charter, at which I wasn't a part of when this council, you know, and nobody up here, I don't believe, was when they joined SOC, says that you can't be a member of another organization or you're thrown out. Well, then let them throw us out. Let them throw us out. I would ask the mayor to, you know, if I would be entitled to bring this back up next week, Thursday, for another vote. To bring it, untable it.
Alderman Sharp.
Yeah, I still think we should hear both sides. I want to hear from that commission, that Sound Commission, exactly what they do and what their
then read rules the notes, are. Dan. Read the
I
notes.
I have read the notes, Mr. Tommy. I have read the notes. I would like to hear from them how things are done, whether to find out if they're political based or if they're based on just sound and the background on it. I really would like to hear from them as much as I'd like to hear from Karaganis. As a matter of fact, I'd like to hear more so from the Sound Commission, because we certainly are losing out. There's no question about that. So I'd like to hear what they have to say before I would make a decision to join that commission. Thank you.
Going any other, before I throw my two cents into this, the only thing that I have with, it's all of a sudden now just because obviously SOC was looking at our website and seeing this on agenda, or else I don't think the mayor would get a phone call. The drawback I have on that, Mr. Mayor, and he could come if he wants, but am I getting a finance report statement out of them too? Or am I just going to hear talk on what they're doing?
We did not discuss that, but I can certainly advise him, because that is something I would like to see as well, is that they should bring their finance reports current and give us a copy. As far as going forward from here, since he gave me the floor, perhaps the thing to do would be schedule two committee meetings, one where we hear from the O'Hare Noise Compatibility Commission, one where we hear from SOC, and then make our decision after that.
Attorney, before I make the motion on the floor,
I'm sorry, this is information. You can't make a motion.
Oh, okay, well then.
Go to the next slide.
But Mr. Tomey, I think if two aldermen request the mayor to put it on the next council agenda, I think he can do that, correct, Mayor? And Mr. Karaganis may have to hustle
to
get here before next Thursday, unless the chairman objects.
Mr. Mayor, I don't think it should go on the council agenda. I think, I think it should go right to council for a vote.
I've never been asked for so many procedural questions before. But my interpretation would be, since it was tabled at City Council, there would have to be a motion to take it back off the table, which could be done under other business. As the manager informed me, that it was tabled at a previous council meeting. So the proper procedure would be under other business to take it back off the table. It would become immediately available for discussion either that evening or at a future council meeting. But the committee does not have the right to take something off the table that was tabled by the City Council. That is the only place where that can be done.
So more or less, it has to go, what you're saying now, since it's on the City Council table, it's got to come back to the council? Am I understanding
something that
right?
Has been tabled by the City Council, any alderman at any council meeting can ask to be taken back off the table. and then it'll be a vote of the council members present at that meeting to take it off the table. And it can be discussed immediately or at a future meeting.
Okay.
I found it almost sharp.
If I can make the suggestion, then we should do this next Thursday. We should inform the O'Hara Noise Commission that they should have a representative here to be able to tell us exactly what they do. And we should have Mr. Karaganis here to speak only if he, as Alderman Wesley says, only if he brings that financial report or how they spent the money. Otherwise, don't talk.
No.
Is that fair?
Okay. That's a discussion going on now. Marshall.
During public comments, if anybody wants to step up during public comments, they can speak. So you can't say to somebody, I'm sorry you didn't bring your financial information with you, so we're not going to allow you to speak. If Mr. Karaganis, Mr. any resident wants to speak during public comments, they can do so.
Yeah, Mr. Coles.
If Mr. Karaganis comes in and hands us a bill and says, I want to talk, here's my bill, are we going to pay for it?
No.
No. That's simple. I mean, he nailed us one time already, and we didn't like it.
Okay. Why? I guess it was information only. I mean,
got a lot of information.
Mr. Ptolemy.
So I think the thing you want to try and do, if I could, is try and get a hold of Brian Gilligan. Okay, and try and get a hold of Karaganis or whatever Karaganis, and see if they're both available next week, because we will. I intend to bring it up because that may be the last thing I do in this council, and I intend to bring it back up.